Good day, and welcome to the third episode of the Misadventures of Sinjin Smythe. Today's episode, the training syllabus. Okay, I've ordered my equipment. It's on its way. Nothing has arrived, but that doesn't mean I don't have anything to do. So how do I begin my quest?
Ask me the questions, Bridgekeeper. I am not afraid.
What is your name?
My name is Sir Lancelot of Camelot.
What is your quest?
To seek the Holy Grail.
What is your favorite color?
Blue.
Right, off you go.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much.
I originally wanted to follow the U.S. Air Force curriculum, but I just know subject matter and hours at rotation, not actual lessons.
So he's an idiot.
I'm not really sure what they teach.
Remedial English. Look, I ain't no English teacher.
I bought a couple books and could do the civilian route, but that seems a little boring.
You're just boring, that's all. That's all.
Flying an airplane is not for the intellectually challenged. In the first week alone of the U.S. Air Force initial flight training, candidates are expected to attend 55 hours of academics. These lessons will be retaught and tested with only 25 hours of actual stick and rudder time over the following 2 weeks.
We're not going to push you.
I'm ready.
Between aerodynamics, algebra, geometry, meteorology, navigation, and structural engineering,
I'm smart, you're dumb. I'm big, you're little. I'm right, you're wrong.
The number of subject matter that a pilot must have at least some knowledge of is incredible.
47th.
Excuse me.
The percentage of knowledge I have so far recorded, I'm not even half done.
After watching numerous DCS-themed videos, you quickly realize that whatever aircraft you choose, be prepared to put some serious study time in.
Are either of you homosexuals?
We're not homosexual, but we are willing to learn.
Yeah, would they send us someplace special?
For my initiation, I really didn't know where to start, so I went to two possible DCS solutions.
Two choices.
The first was the cheapest solution. When you download the free DCS module, you get two airplanes for free. The North American P-51 Mustang and the Sukhoi Su-25 Rook. While a fair argument can be made that both are excellent aircraft worthy of learning to fly, they hardly classify as an aircraft for beginners. The second choice is purchasing the A-10 Basic Flight Command. This is a 12-mission flight training qualification campaign that will teach the procedures for starting the aircraft, takeoff, tactically fly and safely land an A-10 Warthog using a modified format based on U.S. Air Force curriculum. There's just one problem.
Do we have a pilot?
I don't know how to fly.
Excuse me, Captain. I know this may sound silly, but can you fly?
Nope. Never had a lesson.
The first lesson is starting and taxiing a modern jet attack aircraft. This just doesn't seem like a logical place for a beginner to start. It's like saying, I want to try auto racing. I know. I'll take Lewis Hamilton's ride for a spin. Also, tell me you could have found a better voiceover than this guy.
Okay, cadet, your performance check starts now. You have 15 minutes to get this bird started.
Some veteran gamers suggested going for the F-5 or the L-39, given that both are actually used for training pilots before they move to an F-15 or SU-27. Problem is, that's like going to Formula 2 out the gate. Not as powerful, but for the complete novice, still a quick life-ending scenario. In all fairness, the only aircraft in the DCS stable that approaches that level is the Yak-52. The Yak-52 is the introductory training aircraft for the National Air Forces of Armenia, Belarus, Bulgaria, Georgia, Hungary, Latvia, Lithuania, Romania, Russia, Turkmenistan, and Vietnam. It is almost the perfect trainer, having its roots in aerobatics, but its focus on military training. Although its replacement, the modern Yak-152, has been ordered and production begun, it will be some time until the Yak-52 retires from active service. When I look at the Yak-52 module, it said that it had interactive training missions to walk me through everything I need to know how to fly the plane. Problem was, the interactive part sounded like the Russian version of the Borathon I heard with the A-10.
Welcome to the Yak-52 startup lesson. Today, you will learn the engine start procedure for the Yak-52.
Once I become proficient at a number of different platforms, I look forward to attempting the campaigns by established companies like Baltic Dragon, Reflected Simulations, and Razban. But none of them offer any type of just basic flight school. About to give up.
You don't ever quit, boy.
And ready to just tackle this problem on my own like so many others.
Was it over when the Germans bombed Pearl Harbor?
I almost overlooked a solution to my problem. Microphallus. This diminutive independent DCS campaign company is frequently overlooked because of the additional AI interface they require. But they offer a beginner's flight school utilizing the Yak-52. The interface hookup does seem a little bit much, but when I came across their YouTube commercial for the Flight Academy, I was sold.
In 2008, at the G72 meeting in N'Djamena, Chad, it was decided that a quasi-independent Air Force was needed to go where politicians could find no public spying. Beginning with 8 pilots, 30 enlisted men, and 1 dugong mascot, Inept was born without any fanfare or acknowledgement from Modern Air Combat Monthly or Gender Neutral Cockpit. Over the next 11 years, 3 squadrons of hotshots from the world's best air forces were assembled in the aviation capital of the world, Las Vegas, Nevada. On a secret plot of land known only as 3 1/4, aircraft and pilots from every conceivable country would fly and train together for missions that no family member would know about. No medals would be earned for incredible bravery, and no history book would ever improperly chronicle. The International Non-Traditional Expeditionary Peacekeeping Tactical Combat Force was created with the sole mission to fight the fight that needs fighting, but that the elite and powerful couldn't be bothered. So they send someone expendable. Your bravery will go unrecognized, but your results will be impossible to ignore. Some think they are good enough to be called inept. Some appear inept. From the creators of Target Taj Mahal, Operation Colonoscopy, and Kill the Koala comes Task Force Inept, Flight Academy. Microphallus, delivering gigantic experiences in a miniature package.
Next time, on the Misadventures of Sinjin Smythe, YouTube's lamest, yet most watched concept, the unboxing.
for me.
Tinkles the clown, wore a yellow gown to hide a little problem that he had. Whenever he would speak, poor Tinkle start to leak. That's why they called him Tinkles the Incontinent Clown. Never circus. Behind a fence, and the acrobats did startle and amaze. The fire eater sneezed, a spark flew in the breeze, set the big top ablaze. Tinkle saw the fire and climbed up on the high wire. Goodbye to show business. Now he works as a firefighter in Irvine, California.
I am depressed.
And you might ask, how do you replace someone like Tinkles? Well, it's not easy. But there was a young man. A boy, really.
My son.
Dumpy the clown wore a big brown gown to hide a little problem that he had.
You like movies about gladiators?
Whenever he would sit, poor Dumpy, he...
Well, that was really horrible.
No, you always complain!
Elvis has left the building.